Hello everyone. Today we are going to see the topic called performance of the network. So performance of the network is measured in various ways. One is bandwidth, second is throughput, and third is latency, and fourth is jitter. So these are the four ways we can measure the performance of the network. First, we will see the bandwidth. Bandwidth measures the performance of the network. So we can define bandwidth in two ways. One is bandwidth in hertz. Second one is bandwidth in bits per second. So what is bandwidth in hertz? That means a range of frequencies contained in a composite signal is called bandwidth in hertz. That means you can define bandwidth in hertz, or otherwise we can define it in bits per second. So when bandwidth is defined in hertz, it is called a range of frequencies. Range of frequencies contained in a composite signal. So that is called bandwidth in hertz. For example, we can say that a bandwidth of a subscriber telephone line. So in a telephone line, so if you are asking the bandwidth for the telephone line, we can say it is 4 kilohertz. That means that this is the range of frequency that channel can pass. So channel can pass this range of frequency inside that. That is bandwidth. So, and we can also define bandwidth in bits per second. So it is nothing but number of bits per second, number of bits per second that a channel can transmit. So how many number of bits per second that a channel can transmit is bandwidth in bits per second. So example, we can say that bandwidth of a fast Ethernet. So if you are taking the bandwidth of fast Ethernet, we will say it is maximum 100 Mbps. That means it can able to transfer 100 megabits per second. So this many number of bits it can able to transmit within the channel. So coming to bandwidth, it can be defined in hertz or it can be defined in bits per second. When we are defining in hertz, it is nothing but it is range of frequencies that is contained in a signal is called bandwidth in hertz. Example, if you are saying bandwidth of a subscriber, we can say for the telephone line, we are saying it is 4 kilohertz. That means this is the range of frequency that channel can transmit. Next, if you are saying in terms of bits per second, we can say how many number of bits we can transmit per second. Here, for example, if a bandwidth of a fast Ethernet, if you are saying 100 Mbps, it means that we can able to transmit 100 megabits per second. Now, we will see the second characteristic, that is called throughput. Okay, throughput is the measure of how fast we can actually send the data through the network. So how fast, it is a measure of how fast we can actually send data through the network is called throughput. If you want to find out the difference between the throughput and bandwidth, imagine in a highway. So you have an highway which is designed to transmit 1,000 cars per minute. So you have an highway which is designed to transmit 1000 cars per minute from one point to another point. So from one point to another point, you are using an highway. So when you are going to use this highway, it is designed such that it can able to transmit 1000 cars per minute. Now, if there is a congestion occurs in between, okay, in this, if there is a congestion occurs, and this figure, it has been reduced to 100 cars now. So instead of transmitting 1000 cars, now you can able to transmit only 100 cars can be transmitted in this highway. So here the bandwidth is 1000 cars per minute and throughput is 100 cars. So this is the differentiation between bandwidth and throughput. Bandwidth will tell you the maximum capacity of that particular channel, and throughput will tell you what is the capacity that it can transmit actually. That is the throughput. Now we will see an example for throughput. So a network with bandwidth of 10 Mbps can pass only an average of 12,000 frames per minute, with each frame carrying an average of 10,000 bits. What is the throughput of this network? So here they have given here it can able to transmit 12,000 frames per minute, and each frame is having an average of 10,000 bits. So the throughput will be 12,000 into number of bits, that is 10,000 per minute. So we are dividing it by 60. So the answer we will get is 2 Mbps. So here the throughput of this network is 2 Mbps, but the bandwidth over here is 10 Mbps. So if they are asking you to find out the throughput, we need to find how many number of frames we can able to transmit, what is the number of bits it is transmitting, divided by this particular time we will get the throughput of the network. Next, we will see the latency. The third performance is latency. Third characteristic is latency. Latency will tell how long it takes for the entire message to completely transmit from one end to another end. So this is the source and we have the destination here. So here this latency will tell you the time, how long it takes for the entire message to transmit from the source to the destination, from the first bit it has sent out of the source. So we will write the definition. So this defines how long it takes for an entire message to completely arrive at the destination is called latency. So latency has four components. Okay, the first latency can be calculated using like this. It is propagation time. Propagation time plus transmission time. Okay, plus queuing time plus processing delay. So it is related with four components. So to calculate the latency, you need propagation time, transmission time, queuing time and propagation delay. When we add all these four components, we will get the latency. Okay, first we will see propagation time. Now we will see the propagation time. Propagation time is the time required for a bit to travel from source to destination. Suppose we have a sending machine and you have a router and then you have the destination. Now when we are going to send the message, this is the time required for sending the entire message from A to router, and from there the router will send the information to B. So this time is called propagation time. So we can write propagation time. It is the time required for a bit to travel from source to destination is called propagation time. So we can calculate propagation time to be the distance traveled divided by propagation speed will give you the formula for propagation time. So propagation time is distance divided by propagation speed. Okay, so now we will see one example in this. So what is a propagation time if the distance between the two points is 12,000 kilometer? Assume that propagation speed to be 2.4 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second in cable. So we need to calculate propagation time. So propagation time is, the given values are, they have given the distance and they have given the speed. So the formula is propagation time divided, time will be equal to distance divided by propagation speed. So what is the distance here? It is 12,000. So it is in kilometer, 12,000 into 10,000 divided by 2.4 into 2 power 8 into 10 power 8. So when you multiply this, when you do this, you will get 50 millisecond. So this is the time required for sending the message from one end to other end. Okay. Now we will go to the second component of latency, that is transmission time. So when you are sending the message, the transmission time then propagation time will vary. So what is transmission time? Is transmission time, it depends on the size of the message and the bandwidth of the signal. It depends on size of the message and bandwidth of the channel. So when we are transmitting the message, so the time will vary depending on the size. So when the size is larger or the bandwidth of the channel is high or low, the time will not be calculated as it is calculated before. In that case, we need to use this formula. Transmission time will be message size divided by bandwidth. So this is the formula for calculating transmission time. So we need to, when the message size and bandwidth is given, so we can calculate the transmission time with this formula. So here we will see one example. In this example, what are the propagation time and transmission time for 5 MB message or image if the bandwidth of the network is 1 Mbps? Assume that the distance between the sender and the receiver is 12,000 km and light travels at 2.4 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So here they are asking us to find the propagation time and transmission time. So for calculating the propagation time, it is the same formula. Propagation time will be distance traveled divided by propagation speed. So what is distance here? It is 12,000. So we are converting into meters. It is given in kilometers. So we are converting into meters divided by speed. Speed here they have given 2.4 into 10 to the power of 8. So when we do this calculation, we will get 50 milliseconds. So this is the propagation time for sending a image. Okay, and they are asking us to find the transmission time. So the transmission time here they have given, the bandwidth is 1 Mbps. And the size of the message is 5 MB. So we know the formula transmission time is, it is nothing but message size divided by bandwidth. What is a message size here? 5 MB. So we are converting into bytes. So here we have 8 bits. So since it is, we are converting into bits, so we are multiplying into 8 divided by bandwidth. Bandwidth is here 1 Mbps, that means 10 to the power of 6. So this everything will get cancelled, so we'll get 40 seconds. So transmission time for sending this message will be 40 seconds, but propagation time is 50 seconds. Next, coming to the third component for this latency, the queuing time. So queuing time is nothing but the time required, needed for each intermediate device to hold the message. Suppose this is the sender and we are sending it to the router R and from there we are going to send it to the destination B. So when we are sending the message here, the router will have to it will take time to process it. So this is called the queuing time. The queuing time is the time required for the intermediate device to hold the message. Suppose here we are sending it, the message was sent over here. Here this router will have some waiting time, after which it will process, it will send the message to this B. So this is the waiting time, the time required for this intermediate device to hold the message before it gets processed is called queuing time. So we can write the definition like this: time needed for each intermediate device or end device to hold the message before it can be processed. Is called queuing time. The last fourth component is propagation delay. Propagation delay is a delay that happens during the propagation time is called the propagation delay. So using the all the four components, we can easily calculate the latency. Now we will see jitter. Okay, so jitter, it is a small intermittent delay during the data transfer. It can be caused by number of factors like due to congestion or due to collision or signal interference. So because of these interferences, some delay happened in the network. Those delay are called jitter. So jitter refers to a small intermittent delays during data transfer. This may be due to network congestion or signal interference or collision. So because of this, some delay occurs, small delays occurs in the network. So those delays are called jitter. So in this topic, we have seen the performance of the network. So we have seen bandwidth, throughput, latency, and jitter. Thank you.